morning, Clyde. I hope you've been keeping good health and sober hours recently, because I'm going to do something which goes against my better judgment. I'm going to give you an assignment.
Oh, thanks.
I might say that in so doing, I'm resisting the warnings of several of your own colleagues. Nevertheless, I find myself short of good operatives at the moment, and so I'm willing to take a gamble. No, there's no need to thank me. A good professional job is all the thanks I require. Do a good job, and you'll find other assignments forthcoming. To the matter at hand. On the 6th of June, Miss Janet May Maguire, daughter of the iron filings magnate, suspended her studies at the University of Western Australia, and in the company of an unknown man, travelled via the Adelaide Free Earth Fest to a Sydney address. You'll find the address noted on the back of the accompanying photograph. Contrary to her father's fears of abduction and ransom demands, our investigations lead us to believe that Miss Maguire left the state of her own accord, and that her companion has no knowledge of the extent of her vast fortune. Your task then, Clyde, will be to maintain complete surveillance of Miss Maguire during her stay in Sydney. You will phone in a detailed report to this office each day. Should your work prove satisfactory in this regard, you may be called upon to act as our representative in negotiating the young woman's safe return. I don't have to tell you, Clyde, that if you succeed in blowing this one, I will personally see to it that you never work again. Never work again, Clyde. While we're on a familiar subject, you may be pleased to learn that your last partner has now been taken off the critical list and is expected to suffer only 60% permanent disability. I think that's about everything. Oh yes, Mother sends her love and asks if you could call her sometime. You know, you're still my big brother, Clyde, and I really do expect a lot from you.
She'd have strangled the bastard when he was 6 years old.
This is just a pit stop, babe. It's just an intermission in the main feature. As soon as Neat pays me the money he owes me, I'll get into the brakes, get into the clutch, I'll get a good deal on some retreads, and we'll be set.
You could have done half that if you hadn't bought your stupid lights.
My grow lights?
Yes, your stupid grow lights, you dope. Dope, dope everywhere. That's all you ever think about. And don't smoke when I'm talking to you.
Listen, babe. Those suckers are just like my babies. I just want to get a few started so that when we get up to coughs, I can put them in. I'm telling you, when they hit the ground up there, they just... boom! They just fucking explode.
Boy, some mess I got myself into. The first day, the very first day we arrived, there's some gorilla on the doorstep demanding a month's back rent, and who ends up paying?
Yeah, that was really nice of you.
Well, I've had enough. If that creep of a cousin of yours doesn't pay the money, I'm going. I'm getting out of here.
Look, he said he was going to pay me the bread in a couple of days, for Christ's sake.
If he doesn't, I'm leaving, Phil.
God, you get so aggressive when you're stoned.
Stakeout, day 58, Wednesday, 10:26 a.m. Nothing to report. Man A and the girl are still inside. Oh. Oh, somebody did come by collecting for charity, but they sent him away. Oh, here comes male B. Yeah, oh, he's carrying a long object. I'd say it was a fishing rod.
You want to hit me?
Oh, I think I need a little bit more than that to get off. Got any mandies?
Have you got Phil's money?
No, I haven't got Phil's money, you whiny middle class shit. Anything else you want to know?
That's it, Phil. I'm getting out of here. Pit stop. This is the pit stop.
Jack!
Honey. Jesus, mate, you sure know how to break up a beautiful relationship.
She wants to leave, so let her leave. And you can fuck off too for all I care.
Oh, not without my bread, cousin. First off, you promised it to me when you sold the stereo. And then it was the records. And for Christ's sake, didn't you get anything for the fridge?
Look, Phil, you're blood, so I'll level with you. I had some money, and the fridge has squared us off. But you know me. There's always got to be something in for me. And today's no exception.
I suppose I expect you to use that on yourself.
Oh, don't be so thick, Phil. We're just going to walk in here and take anything we want.
What's this we business, mate? What are you going to do? Walk into a crowded shop and say, serve me first, mister, or I'll blow you away.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, well, you can just count me out, pal. Babe, what are you doing now?
I'm just getting what belongs to me. I told you not to use my shampoo and give me Quackles, he's mine.
What have you done to your hair?
Nothing.
Janet, look, can't we talk about this?
I'm through with that. Where's my other stocking?
Well, how would I know? I don't wear it. Shit. Look, it's not my fault. Other people let me down.
If you haven't worked out why that's not working, why don't you ask your creepy cousin if he's paid the electricity bill?
My plants. Me! Come on, Neat. I know you're in there.
Jeez.
Open up, you crud.
What sort of fucking noise, cousin?
It's just cut off the electricity. Now, what am I supposed to do? I've got 50 plants out in the garage, and they've just had their lights put out.
Oh, you sound just like her. Give me the fucking towel.
I wouldn't do anything stupid, Nate.
What are you doing?
I think your stocking just walked out the door.
Get some clothes on, you look ridiculous.
Something in particular, sir?
Hello, Raymond. It's your brother. No, there's nothing to report, except I think I've been on this job too long. I think I'm beginning to crack.
Have you seen our specials this week on vitamin tablets?
No, I haven't been drinking on the job.
Well, if you tell me what it is exactly you want... Oh, my God.
All I want is the money and the drugs. I want them in this bag, and I want them now.
You're the wrong place.
So, her old man wants to buy him off, eh?
Don't you see the gun, smartass?
Well, I don't know. She seems pretty stuck on him.
You want to breathe through your belly button?
Yeah. Well, have it your own way, but I think we're talking about true love here.
Hurry! Move!
Well, how much is he ready to cough up?
3 times in 2 years has it happened.
How much? My God. He must want her back pretty bad.
He's calling me a letter after this.
Cut the shit and give me the bag!
What's that?
Suppose you want me to rip this out as well?
No, I haven't rung Mother yet.
Make like a fucking statue and don't move!
Well, she never rings me on my birthday. What was it? Oh, my car!
My car! Hey, stop! Stop! My scotch! My scotch!
Oh, come on, that is not true. I am not a degenerate living in the company of thieves and junkies. It isn't so. I just don't know where you get these stupid ideas.
I just don't want to talk about it, Phil.
Thank you.
Yeah, what do you want?
Allow me to introduce myself.
Clive Thornton. Doberman Detective Agency. We get them by the balls.
You've probably heard of us.
Yeah, you do all that divorce work.
Well, yes, but the matter that brings me here today is you.
Haven't I seen you hanging around?
No, I don't think so. Look, it's a pretty delicate subject I wish to discuss with you. Is there somewhere we can talk privately?
What's in it for me?
Well, a lot of money, for one thing.
Let's go down the street and talk. $50,000,
but only on condition that you let her go and let her come back to Perth with me.
But that's incredible. You mean to tell me her old man's the iron pig? Jesus, I knew she was spoiled, but I never guessed she was loaded. What's the matter, mate?
Nothing, it's just that I think this is my car. It's stolen today. Twice, I think.
Well, Phil, this is it. I'm going. I should have known it wouldn't have worked out, but you have to try something mad every so often, don't you? Look, I know it hurts now, baby, but the pain will go away. You just wait and see.
Maybe you're right. West is where you belong, and I need to get to that farm. I know I can make it now, Janet.
Of course you can, Phil.
I know I really can make it to that farm now. Just you watch me.
Phil, you smoke too much dope.
I wouldn't touch that car, sir. It's been used in an armed robbery.
I think he's on the balcony.
Okay, come on out. We know you're in there. Throw down your weapons and come out with your hands over your head.
Are you talking to me?
Inside of me, I can't change, just can't change. And now a little bit, just enough to help me for a little while. Let me dream, let me dream. Don't wanna hurt no one. Waving short goodbyes. Yes, I'm waving short goodbye. Even just another day would be so beautiful as such, but so painful in so many ways. If only I could see what's hidden so, so deep inside of me. Waving short goodbyes. Yes, I'm waving short goodbyes.